Tonight, friends, classmates, teammates, and coaches lit candles to remember a young Razorback that died yesterday.
Garrett Uekman, a 19-year-old from Little Rock, was pronounced dead yesterday afternoon. 4029's Monica Limpert was at tonight's vigil and has more.
Hundreds of students filled Bud Walton Arena to honor the life of Garrett Uekman.
The first thing when I think about Garrett, you know, he just always was the one to bring the smile to my face.
Jillian Langston met Garrett through mutual friends, and they quickly became close. She was getting ready to head home for Thanksgiving break when she heard the news.
It hasn't completely, like, hit me just because, like, I talked to him, like, last week. I sent him a text message and said, good game, and, you know, he responded, and it's just hard to believe that, like, he's not going to be here.
I just wish that I had a lifetime of knowing Garrett Uekman.
As a player for the Razorback football team, the university draped the arena in red and white to honor Ekman's Razorback pride. Students who never even met him felt the need to share their support.
And they always said he was a really nice guy, and he was always really courteous, and he was really talented. It just really makes you take a second and realize how precious life is and how you can't take it for granted.
He was a tireless worker, an excellent student, and even a better friend, and a kid that any parent would be proud to call their own.
It's hard when someone so young loses their life. I can't say that I knew Garrett, and I can't say that there are people that didn't know him, but still it hurts knowing that a family is hurting and also knowing that we lost a good student.
For the ones who had the chance to know Garrett Uekman, they say they'll do everything they can to keep his spirit alive.
I love him, and I'm going to miss him, and just pray for the family, and especially all the guys and football team, and just get them through this.
Monica Lempert, 4029 News.
And Uekman passed away yesterday afternoon after police say they found him unconscious in his dorm room. There's still no information confirming how he died.